Greetings, teachers. This is Stephanie Chi with the Southern Region, and I will be talking with you briefly today about time-saving strategies for student-graded assignments. So the first thing I would like you to do is take a look at the article that came along with this training. Take a few minutes to read the article and think about what implications are present for grading in your content area or your grade strand. How do you think these practices translate into a virtual environment? So as you're reading, just I would encourage you to highlight, underline, and think about some pragmatic strategies. So please go ahead and hit pause and take a few minutes to read the article. So hopefully you found some interesting strategies there. And I just wanted to share a thought with you that was shared with me at an AP English conference a few years ago. The presenter said that there is more of a need for students to be working and writing and practicing than a need for us to be grading profusely. So I took that to heart. I think especially as a high school English teacher, which was my background, I could have spent hours and hours every day grading. But there are lots of strategies you can use to make sure your students are still practicing every day and that you aren't completely going insane trying to keep up with all that grading. So one strategy that I would suggest, in addition to the ones mentioned in the article, is to use a timer. So this may seem intuitive, but it's something that takes a great deal of self-discipline. And what I would recommend is setting a timer and only take 3 to 5 minutes for short answer assignments, and then 10 minutes for essays, labs, and projects. And you might be saying to yourself, oh my gosh, that is absolutely crazy. I could never get this done in that amount of time. But I think you'll find that with 5 minutes or 10 minutes, you can focus on a few key things in each assignment. So that goes on to our next bullet point here. So just this idea that you can't do everything at once and that you shouldn't do everything at once. I think we've all had that experience with a teacher or a professor where we've gotten a paper back and it seems like the entire thing is completely marked up. And I'm not sure about you, but that was a very overwhelming experience for me when that happened. So what I would encourage you to do is focus on 1 to 3 skills at a time. This will help you avoid that bleeding paper, and also it will help your students grow in those key areas. So let's say I'm looking at a history assignment, for example. I'll focus on main idea and details, and then I might focus on one element of writing, like, I don't know, making sure that sentences are coherent, for example. And then with English, if you are doing an English assignment, you could have maybe 2 grammar and writing focus points, and then you could look at the thesis statement in a paper. So those are just some ideas. Then within the LMS and then the OLS, there are rubrics that are aligned to each assignment. And you might notice that the rubrics are complicated and there's lots of different pieces to them. But what I would encourage you to do is take the rubric, simplify it, and then literally just drop it at the bottom of the assignment that you are looking at. So I would be more than happy to share examples with you and different ideas, because that simple rubric is going to give you a place to share your ideas in a very, very quick manner. I would also suggest creating a feedback repository. This is something that you can create for individual assignments, or even just something that you can create that you keep coming back to, because you've probably noticed that the mistakes students make and the trends you see will overlap from student to student and even from assignment to assignment. So having a OneNote document or even just a Word document where you can copy and paste feedback and just change it up slightly for each student or for each assignment is going to be a huge time saver. Another great tool that you can use that is fantastic for those auditory learners is Kaizena. So you can just go ahead and Google this. It's sort of a strange name, but it's wonderful because it's a feature that allows you to open up a student's work, and then you can point to different places in the document and then leave voice feedback. So that's really great for kids who might not respond very well to written feedback. In addition, this is something I don't have up on the slide, but that I found to be really, really helpful, and it's similar to the stamp method that was mentioned in the article. So with some assignments, you don't need to leave robust feedback. I like to call this my sticker method. And so it's similar to the check or check minus or check plus that you might have been used to if you taught in a brick and mortar environment. But essentially, if you are dealing with a Dropbox or even dealing with KMail, you can have three different stickers, and each sticker will have a different meaning. So let's say I have a unicorn sticker, and that would represent that all of the criteria were met for the assignment and that I was completely impressed with the work. And then I could have, let's say, I don't know, a dinosaur sticker, and that could signal to students that, yeah, you did a pretty good job, but not completely outstanding work. So you can create those codes around the stickers and they become symbols. And it doesn't matter the grade level, you will be so shocked at how much the kids will argue over making sure that they get that top level sticker. And they'll even resubmit their work to you to make sure that they get that. And that's a strategy that you can use in Class Connect as well. All right, so I'm really curious, and I would love to hear your feedback about how you think you could use ideas we discussed today to complement your current strategies. And I'm also curious to know what are some practices you think you could put in place immediately in your classroom as a time saver. So feel free to send me feedback and ideas. My email address is here. It's very simple, schi@k12.com. And if you would like rubrics or any additional resources, I would love to share those with you. And I just want to thank you all so much for listening. Again, if you need anything, please reach out. Have a wonderful day.